believe you when you tell me she's all yours. Cause when I have her on the floor down on all four, she says it's mine, and that's for sure. If you come around when I'm there, you gotta go. And she don't know nothing about this ball of twerk. When we was players coming up, we knocked all the girls. And now, I just go out and take my pick. If you got enough fame, you can take my bitch. I won't hate you, try to clown or put you down. Cause I got women all over this town. We ain't no bitches like the ones I got. All top notch, gotta stay on top. We party all night and we make a lot. Gotta keep it back, now it don't stop. We ain't no bitches like the ones I got. When I take them to the spot, you know they all look hot. Like I said, homeboy, all I got is top notch. Gotta keep it back, now it don't stop. You couldn't be a better player than me. You ain't got enough game, you couldn't take from me. You ain't even have a chance. Not with me in the picture. You even got the last dance, so you can see what's get you. Broken hearted and lonely. Cause when it's over, she's going home with me. 5'9", short hair, big booty. Looking like a leading lady starring in a movie. Fly crib, Mercedes Benz. She love niggas like me and my shady friends. And when we hang out, don't cap with champagne bottles. Thinking I'm drunk, I don't play game model. I put the game down from the start. And you ain't nothing but a dumbass mark. She started choosing when she saw the red carpet. What you say, nigga? Get your ass in the car, be an angel. Just like the ones I got. All top notch, gotta stay on top. Party all night and we make a lot. I gotta keep it fat, now it don't stop, bitch. Ain't no bitches like the ones I got. When I take them to the spot, you know they all look hot. Like I said, homeboy, all I got is top notch. I gotta keep it fat, now it don't stop. Cheerleaders, groupies, beer drinkers, high class, stuck up hoes that get real freaky. Lawyers, nurses, police, women, teachers. If she's a top notch, I keep her. Tall ass models, skinny as shit. Big titties, short and thin. All complexions, different nationalities. Pimp came from East Oakland, out of Cali, keeping teenage to middle age. Is she paid? Cause if she ain't, what can she make? If I see a bad bitch, I ain't finna wait. I'ma holla at her. I can't discriminate. It's not about the sex, not all the time. Cause I'm trying to get in her mind. Like when you're standing just there at the ocean, I help you manage your emotions, bitch. Ain't no bitches like the ones.
Reaper, we back at you again. Make sure you subscribe to the Reaper, cause I'm doing good things here at Reaper. All right, let's get to the topic. Darlene Ortiz has D-pics in her phone, you know, at 55, 56 years old. Darlene has dick pictures in her phone. And I'm not saying that Darlene's not a good broad. Darlene's a good broad, you know. I mean, you get a broad like that on your team, you see that she's dedicated and loyal, and this is why Corey got her on his team, you know. But that still doesn't mean that, you know, Darlene doesn't like to, you know, indulge in penis, even if it's just looking at it, you know, online or whatever. She says she's doing research on these penises. I just want to know, Darlene, what kind of research is you doing on these penises, you know, because they be talking about that you have dick pictures in your phone, which means that, you know, Darlene, you know, she has a freaky nature about her. Reaper, keep it 1,000, you know. And, you know, Darlene is a woman, you know, that has to be cuffed by a nigga. You know, the Reaper, keep it 1,000. And for Corey to have her around or whatever, he had to cuff her. Because she's an explorative type woman, you know, because even when she was with Ice-T, you know, she cheated. She said she cheated. That's been in her book. And if you remember when Tommy Sotomayor, you know, was hanging around Corey Nim, she went to his place, you know, to do a couple shows with Tommy. But she realized, you know, that she didn't want to get with Tommy. And, you know, that was a hustle move because, you know, Darlene was going through some hard times at that time. And Tommy probably gave her a few dollars to come over there and do the show just to see if he could hit it or not. You know, the Reaper, keep it 1,000, because at that particular time, you know, Tommy was rolling in cash. So that was more of a hustle move, you know, than, you know, know, her, you know, being so explorative and interested in Tommy. And I believe Tommy realized that, you know, it was an infiltrate move too by Corey, and Tommy realized that. And so that's why, you know, he didn't really pop at it like he wanted to. The Reaper keep it 1,000, but, you know, he tried to, you know, give her a few dollars and throw some money on the subject just to see if he could hit or not, you know, and, you know, he came up short. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And the reason Corey got her on this team, because he was talking about that when a nigga see you give a broad, you know, $5,000 or $10,000 or whatever, they feel like, you know, that's what you should give, you know, them or whatever. But nigga, you ain't been shit since day one. Now, I wonder who he was talking about when he said that. That's why he wouldn't give him no money. Was he talking about Juzo Williams, or was he talking about, you know, Grady? I don't know. Or was he talking about Bobby? You know, I don't know. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000 because he's cuffed Darlene. You know, I believe Darlene has got some paper out of Corey before, you know, and, you know, she's still getting a piece of paper, you know, and he's cuffed her. You know, this is why Darlene's loyal to Corey and sell the 5150 merchandise and everything. And this is why, you know, she gets what she gets. The Reaper keep it 1,000, you know. And she stayed loyal to Corey. You see, she there all the time doing the show and everything. And I'm not saying that Darlene is a bad broad, you know. I ain't saying that. Darlene's a good broad. She a good broad that Corey got on, you know, his team. And that's why he let her do the show and everything. And she handled some business things for him because, you know, hey, she may stray off and get us penis, you know, every now and then. You know, not as much as she used to because she's a little, you know, a little old in the tooth, a little long in the tooth. So she don't do it like she used to. But she has a freaky nature about her, or whatever, you know. And, you know, and since that iced tea relationship, you know, Darlene feels entitled, you know. And what I mean by that is, you know, she feels entitled that a dude do this and do that, you know, for her. You know, she ain't gonna appreciate that dude, you know, cause she gonna feel like, if he do this, I can bold and I can do this and that. Cause remember, she used to threaten Corey about leaving, you know, all the time. You know, she used to threaten Corey that I'm gonna leave the show, I'm gonna this, that, and the other. And that's because, you know, the paper wasn't right. She was saying, nigga, if you gonna cuff me, you know. If you want me to do all this and be all this, then cuff me, you know. I told you, Darlene liked to be cuffed, you know, but, you know, she still couldn't appreciate that Corey just had her on the show or whatever, you know, because Darlene can't appreciate no dude, right? Not unless he cuff her like Ice-T did, you know. Well, she ain't gonna appreciate no dude since Ice-T, because anytime you leave a boss like that, and I always say this, if D would have played her position, she would have been okay. But she started to feel later on in that relationship entitled, like he should do this, he should do that, he shouldn't be doing this, he shouldn't be doing that. And anytime that you with a boss that's got millions and millions of dollars, you gotta know you ain't gonna be his only broad. But if you his main broad that he spending money on and he cuffing you, you have to play your position. And Darlene didn't want to play that position. The Reaper keep it 1,000. But she felt entitled with Corey too, that he should do something and cuff her or whatever. But she didn't appreciate that Corey just had her on the show, or she didn't appreciate that Ice-T was just the boss that he was, because she felt like she had put in a lot of work with Ice-T and he should do some of the things that she wanted him to do or whatever. So she felt entitled and she got big head with Ice-T. But she felt like, Corey, if I'm doing all this, nigga, you gonna cuff me, you gonna have to spend some paper, I'm gonna leave this show, I'm on this, that, and the other. Because, you know, when a bra feels entitled, they can't appreciate you. The Reaper keep it 1,000. The things that you do, they can't appreciate you. And I say, ever since Ice-T, right, Darlene ain't gonna appreciate no dude. She gonna always feel like she can boat and do her own thing and this, that, and the other. And that's why there have been missteps in relationships that she done had or whatever. Because once you done been with a big time boss like that, you know, hey, you feel like these are just peasants and nobody can give you what he could give you, far as game, far as things or anything. The Reaper keep it 1,000. This is the way Darlene feel. So, you know, she can't appreciate, you know, the things that that other men did. But I believe at this point in her life, right, she can appreciate, you know, who Corey is and the things that he do, because she's a little long in the tooth now, and she can see, you know, how hard it is out here now, you know, if, you know, she's not with a boss type nigga. Reaper, we keep it rough, we keep it raw, we keep it real. Make sure you subscribe to the Reaper, because I'm doing good things here at Reaper. Reaper out. Peace.